I'm Ashwin. Welcome back to my YouTube channel and welcome to the Crypto Week, a week-long video series on cryptocurrencies. So before understanding cryptocurrencies, we need to understand the technology behind cryptocurrencies, that is blockchain technology. So if you search for blockchain technology in the internet, you will find many advanced definitions, but that will confuse you. So in this video, I will try to simplify what actually this blockchain technology is. Blockchain technology is simply blockchain. What is actually blockchain? Blockchain is a storage device. Let's consider it as a storage device. But what is the specialty? In general, if you want to store information, we use databases. Or like, let's consider an example. So a bank. So if you have a bank account on HDFC or SBI, whatever it might be. So where your data will be stored? Your data will be stored on bank's database. Similarly, blockchain is a kind of database, or consider it's a place where your data can be stored. And what's the specialty of blockchain technology? Your data will be stored in such a way that is distributed, that is decentralized, and that is something which cannot be hacked. That is something which cannot be changed. But what about traditional databases? If you store your data in your bank's database, if you perform some transaction, your data will be changed, right? Or if someone hacks the database, your data will be gone. But blockchain is something where it is impossible to change the data. It is impossible to hack the data. So that is the reason why people are showing more interest nowadays on decentralized systems. I will tell you with an example, like how blockchain will really help you. So let's consider an example of a centralized system. What actually a centralized system is? So a centralized system is something where there is a database and that is common for everyone. Let us consider an example of a bank. So if you take an example of a bank, so bank may have lakhs of customers. So all the data is stored in a centralized database, which means the bank, if someone from the bank wants to change the data, wants to store the data or wants to hack the data, it is possible. And if that happens, all your data will be in risk. Or if some hacker, if some unknown person try to theft the data, it is still possible. And let us consider another example, like you are transferring money from your country to the individual in another country. Let's suppose you are in A here. Let's look this image, and you are trying to transfer some money to a person who is located in United States. What you actually do? So you go to the bank or you just transfer your money in online. So through using net banking or directly going to the bank, and they will charge some fee because of converting your currency to other currency. Banks will charge some fee. So, and there is an intermediary here. So the intermediary is your bank. Your bank will communicate with the bank of B's bank. So, and they will communicate. And once after it is converted to their currency, then B will receive the money in the end. So this is a long process, and two banks are involved here. So they are intermediaries, which means your bank information, your account information is stored in a centralized repository. So that is the reason why you're not able to change, or you're not able to, your information is stored in a centralized repository. So which means if something negative happens, your data will be compromised. And the other disadvantage is you need to pay some fees every time you make a transaction. So because banks are maintaining your data, so they need, in order to manage their resources, they will charge some money from you. So this is a disadvantage of centralized system. Then blockchain works on decentralized system. How it works? So in general, a blockchain is decentralized and it is a peer-to-peer system, which means if you are communicating with the other person, so the data and the exchange is between you people. So the communication lies only between you two people. There is no intermediary being involved here. So this is called peer-to-peer and decentralized. So you can ask me how it works, because how can my data will be stored? If I am communicating with my peer directly, then who will manage my data? Here, blockchain comes into the picture. Your data will be stored in a block. So what actually is this block? Block is a data storage device where it stores your data and followed by a public key, or you can say hash key. So hash key is like a fingerprint. So is it possible to change your fingerprint? No, right? So because if something goes wrong, if the data is altered there, the complete hash will be changed. So without your permission and without the receiver's permission, that cannot be changed. Once you register your hash in that block, then it is fixed. That's it. You cannot change the data. And user needs to know your public key to receive that data. So if you communicate your public key to your B, or I mean, he can directly receive, or you know the hash of, I can say the B, you can directly send money to them. So it is how it works. The advantage here is you don't need an intermediary bank. You don't need to pay commission to anyone. So this is the advantage of peer-to-peer or decentralized system. You can ask me how blockchain actually work. So you can see this is the block. So multiple blocks are connected in a network. So what actually the block will contain? So the block will contain the data. The block will contain the hash key, and it also contains the previous hash key. So if some changes are performed, if you try to change something on a particular block, it also contains the transaction history. So it also contains the hash key of the previous block. So here, the advantage here is if some changes happen in the blockchain, even though with the other's consent, you try to change your block, it will be recorded securely. So you, no one can compromise it. Even someone change it, you will be know that. You will know that easily. Let us consider land documents. So you have registered your land, and after some years, nowadays the problem is it is very difficult to verify those land details because there are no proofs that there are no, I can say, accurate proofs that who is the owner of a particular land and what are all the transactions that are made in the past. But if they are stored in the blockchain, so if you sell to a particular person, that will be stored in the block. And if he sells again after 5 to 6 years to some other person, it will be stored there, because, and they will be added to your blockchain network. So because you also belong to that blockchain network, so you will be notified of what are all the transactions happening on that particular block. And every individual who is being added to the blockchain will know the past and the present. So in this way, you can avoid scams and you can avoid corruption in a very secure way. So this is a very best way to avoid corruption too, because everything will be recorded. And if one change is performed, everyone in the blockchain will be notified of that change. So that is the advantage of blockchain technology. And here you can see decentralized system, how it works. So if you are, I can say, if you are committing a transaction with your partner or with your peer, it will be recorded in a block. So, and that block, if any change happened to that in another block, so there is a link between that, there is a chain between that. And that is the reason why we call it as a blockchain technology. So every block, every chain that is performed in the network will be recorded on blocks, and every block has a chain to the previous block. That is the reason why blockchain is very secured and it is corruption-free technology. So if that is implemented, and like most of the banks will need to close because they will stop earning profits. And that is the reason why not every government is positive about the blockchain technology. But yeah, once blockchain comes, everything will be secured and everything will be digitalized and no one will have the access to your data. And we also need to know one thing in blockchain technology, the future, which is very popular, that is smart contracts. So smart contracts is written in Ethereum. So Ethereum is one of the decentralized application, so which runs on blockchain technology. So we will see what Ethereum is in the coming videos. But what is a smart contract? In general, if let's take an example of the previous one. So the bank transaction. So if you send money to someone and someone receives money from your end, there will be an intermediary who, I can say, consumes your contract. Your contract in the sense, if something is executed, that is a contract. So if you're buying a land from a seller, then it is a contract. You need an intermediary to register all these details. It is called a contract in general. So what actually is smart contract? If you perform a transaction in blockchain with your, I can say, with the receiver, then automatically a smart contract will be created. So what actually is smart contract? Smart contract is a program written using Ethereum blockchain. So it is something like if a transaction is happened, a contract should be automatically created. It is called smart contract. So once a smart contract created, which means the execution of the deal was closed. So, and the execution is successful. It is the meaning of a smart contract. Smart contracts are created automatically and digitally, and they will come with unique signature. We discussed about hash keys and public keys, right? It is like your fingerprint. No one can change without your permission. So smart contracts are very secured and they will be created automatically. You don't need an intermediary there. So that is the reason why you save a lot of time and you save a lot of commission, and you can also make it very secure. So only you can change that. Without your consent, no one can change it. That is the advantage of smart contract. And if you want to build a blockchain application, if you want to build a decentralized application, as blockchain is the future, because everyone is now looking towards secured way of building applications and cryptocurrencies. So people who are interested to learn blockchain technology are also growing. So if you want to become good at blockchain, there are four different long ways where you can learn to have a good career in blockchain. The first one is Solidity. Solidity is a famous blockchain-based programming language where you can write decentralized applications. You can also build, I can say, blockchain using JavaScript, Java, and Python, but Solidity is the most preferred programming language to build decentralized applications. And yeah, this is what blockchain technology is. I hope you now understand the difference between blockchain and cryptocurrencies, and why we use blockchain, why blockchain is more secure, and why it is corruption-free. So please watch the Crypto Week playlist to know more about blockchain and cryptocurrencies. So I will be releasing more videos this week. And please subscribe to the channel if you are a new visitor and support me doing more content. Also, please like, comment, and share this video. Thank you.